Hello, my friends. I am sex guru Rico Suave, also known as Guru Rico Suave. Today, I would like to talk to you about erogenous zones. That's right. First off, let's talk about the breasts. Now, everybody loves the breasts. What most people do not know is the nipples are made of exact same material as elbow skin. That's right. So, she can feel very little on her nipples unless you stimulate them very strongly. I suggest you squeeze them as hard as humanly possible. Squeeze and squeeze until she cry out for Jesus. Now that means she like it. That's right. Bottom. The bottom is a very versatile area. You can stroke it. You can pinch it. You can spank it. And let us not forget about the anus. The anus is a very delicate area. You can lick it. This is called rimming. Just last week, I was rimming a girl and she farted in my mouth. Right in my mouth. The clitoris. The clitoris is a myth. It was made up by a bunch of men-hating lesbians. The rest of womankind has simply perpetuated the joke for a bit of a laugh. Ah, you ladies. The G-spot. The G-spot is notoriously difficult to find. You will find it, my friends, hidden deep inside her left ear hole. During the last throes of passion, stick in your little finger and wiggle it about. Believe me, my friends, it will drive her crazy. The face. The face is an erogenous zone that requires particular subtlety and tenderness. I suggest you lick her face all over with great vigor, paying special attention to the corners of her mouth. The hair. Women are very sensitive in their hair. Too sensitive. Never touch a woman's hair, my friend, or she may become enraged and dangerous. If she becomes skittish, blow air into her nostrils. This will calm her. The neck. Her neck is easy to please. Just spit on it again and again until your mouth goes totally dry. The mind. The most important erogenous zone in a woman is her mind. During lovemaking, stimulate her mind with a conundrum or riddle. Something like, a skin I have, more eyes than one, I can be very nice when I am done. That had her stumped for days, until one night, just before she came, she cried out, a potato! I was so proud. Okay, my friends, that is all we have time for. So until next time, peace.